salvation be exalted. The Lord is help, and blessed be my rock. Let the Lord of my salvation be exalted.
He has risen. Matthew 28, verse 6, which is the gospel for Holy Saturday night or Easter morning. Tell us, Mary, say what thou didst see upon the way. The tomb the living did enclose. I saw Christ's glory as he rose. Christ, my hope, has risen. That Christ is truly risen from the dead, we know. Victorious King, thy mercy show. Mary of Magdala is asked in an ancient piece of Christian literature known as a sequence, which was written for special church solemnities, Easter being one of those, to share her faith with the church. Mary explodes with joy. I saw Christ's glory as he rose. Christ, my hope, has risen. Can we have joy this Easter when everything is so bleak, times are hard, and the churches are closed? Can we celebrate the joy of Easter when there are no Easter bunnies or Easter eggs? No Easter bonnet with frills upon it? How can we share Mary's enthusiastic faith and Easter joy? We are in a crisis, and the world is spinning on the axis. The world is spinning on an axis of desperation. Our cities are empty, and our countries are on lockdown. From where shall come our hope or reason for joy? Two prisoners were once in our situation, and they were looking out of prison bars. One saw the mud, the other saw the stars. Prison bars do not deprive the prisoner of the hope that one day she or he will be free. Hope gives us something to live for, something to which we can look forward. It helps us to see the light at the end of the tunnel. How we see things is important. Life could be looked upon as a dead end or full of new horizons. When we are enabled to see the bigger picture and our expectations and vision expand. The seed of hope is everywhere. We can make it sprout. The biblical figure of Mary of Magdala is important for us in our global scenario right now. Mary was in the same boat we are in as we face the trauma of COVID-19. Mary faced a tomb with a big rock enclosing it. To get inside was a great challenge, indeed a daunting task. Did that prevent her from going to the tomb? Why did she go? Was it out of duty, love, or loyalty? Was it because she and the other women wanted to see Jesus? Did she not know that she would be helpless in trying to move the stone? St. John the Evangelist says that it was still dark when Mary went to the tomb. Matthew says it was towards dawn. In other words, it was not time for seeing clearly. But Mary and her companions were not deterred. When it's dark, we need faith to see. Mary of Magdala was a woman of faith and a woman of hope. Faith pointed the way for her, and hope gave her courage. Tell us, Mary, Mary's discovery of the empty tomb and her excited faith made her leave the place of death behind and run with the good news to tell the disciples. Mary of Magdala's announcement changed the world. John the Evangelist said that he saw and he believed. Mary could have stayed weeping before the empty tomb, dealing with her loss and grief. She could have allowed the tragic events of Jesus' death to overwhelm her. However, when it was still dark, Mary saw the light and stepped out in faith. Without faith, we cannot see Jesus, the risen Lord. Say, what thou didst see upon the way? Mary saw death giving way to life, an empty tomb signaling resurrection. God sent an angel to lead Mary out of her isolation and solitude. That was the moment of Mary's resurrection. She was not destined to be a woman of the tomb, but the disciple of the resurrection. She was the first to experience the resurrection of Jesus and to share the good news with the disciples. What Mary saw and proclaimed continue to enliven and empower the faith of believers, the church, and indeed the world today. If God could roll away the stone for Mary to look into the tomb, and find hope. Would God not do the same for us today, faced with the entombment of the world by COVID-19? Is anything too wonderful for God to do? Isn't it true to say that with God, all things are possible? The coronavirus pandemic is an experience of the culture of death today in the global health care sector. The infection and deaths are astronomical, and caregivers risk their lives in providing health services and caregiving. The fear of contracting the virus is one thing. The reality of being physically attacked, as happened in an instance in India, is another thing. This has caused the world to focus greater attention on the work of doctors, nurses, and caregivers, and not take them for granted, but show them greater appreciation. From the culture of death is emerging a culture of respect and appreciation. Where we see this happening today, we have the signs of resurrection and hope. When we see people rising from despair and hopelessness and desiring a better tomorrow by not taking life and others for granted today, when we see our poets and artists constructing new visions of hope and challenging us to reflect deeper on our lives and our present predicament, when we see leaders coming out of their tombs and isolation by giving hope to people and nations, when we see healthcare personnel making sacrifices and lifting up the desperate, not only on respirators, but by words of kindness, encouragement, and personal dedication, when we see families warming to each other and home becoming home again for many, when we see neighborhoods becoming caring communities and neighbors singing to neighbors and looking out for each other, when we see politicians putting aside party politics and uniting in the interests of the common good, when we see churches putting aside denominational interests in response to deeper compassion and care for the needs and interests of entire nations through prayer and works of mercy, when we see these things happening, we know that resurrection is taking place among us. These are signs that life is conquering death, that the culture of life is more powerful than the culture of death. Every day, resurrection is happening before our very eyes. In those rediscovering their faith, those finding God and becoming more kind thoughtful, self-sacrificing, servant-like, while turning away from evil, aggression, violence, and wickedness. When we see good conquering evil, light conquering darkness, and life conquering death, then we know that we have broken out of the tomb of despair and hopelessness, and are ready to reconstruct our lives and transform our world. The COVID-19 experience can become a death and resurrection experience for those who have eyes to see and faith to penetrate the darkness. When life breaks through in goodness and hope, there is resurrection and joy. In the silence of our cities, the Easter gospel will resound, says Pope Francis in his message for Holy Week. In the risen Jesus, life conquered death. This Paschal faith nourishes our hope. It is a hope of a better time in which we can be better, finally freed from evil and from this pandemic. It is a hope. Hope does not disappoint. It is not an illusion. It is a hope. Without death, there is no resurrection. Without the tomb, there is no expectation. Mary of Magdala said, "Christ, my hope, is risen." And we say with certain faith, Jesus Christ is risen. He is truly risen. He is our hope. Pope Francis has given us hope. And in a poem I wrote, "The Dawning of a New Day," in the context of this COVID-19 virus, I concluded with the final verse in these words: "Now a new day is beginning, full of courage and hope, with faith overcoming the dread of the dark. From the lessons we have learnt, we can make a fresh start in rebuilding our world on values that will last. With humility and care, we can make our way there with the advent of a dawning new day." Alleluia! Hallelujah! Happy Easter!